We certainly need more sweetness in the world today. Who are the wizards who invented all these delights? Bertie Bott's Every Flavor Beans. As far as I know, I'm the only wizard who ever tasted a goat pea flavored one. And how did I know it was goat pea? Because I hate goats. But let's get back to it and freshen our mouths with a delicious chocolate frog. Are you also avid collectors of witches and wizard cards? Now that I think about it, how is it possible that no one has ever contacted me to print a card featuring the famous, charming, adventurer wizard Quentin Penterman? That's right, it's me. And in today's episode, we will uncover the behind the scenes of the sweets of the magical world and their history. Honeydukes, nestled on High Street in the quaint all-wizarding village of Hogsmeade, has been a cherished institution since its establishment in 1641. Currently owned by Ambrosius Flume and his wife.
Welcome.
Stepping inside, one is greeted by shelves upon shelves, adorned with the most tantalizing array of sweets imaginable. Beyond the enchanting assortment of wizarding candies, Honeydukes prides itself on its delectable homemade fudge and chocolate, crafted with love by the owners. Unsurprisingly, the shop is a bustling hub, particularly on weekends and during the festive Christmas season, where the crowds of visitors make it a challenge to navigate the aisles. But Honeydukes holds more than just sweet treats. It also harbors a secret passageway leading from Hogwarts School of Witchcraft and Wizardry directly into its cellar. On the castle's third floor, within the Gunhilda of Gorsmoor Corridor, lies a grand stone statue of Gunhilda. By tapping its back with a wand and uttering the incantation, Descendium, a hidden passageway is revealed, leading down a cool, twisting stone slide. Emerging from the passage, one finds themselves in Honeydukes' cellar, with its dusty floor and wooden crates. Honeydukes also plays a vital role in supplying the Honeydukes Express, the notorious food trolley that traverses the Hogwarts Express. Operated by a kind lady, this trolley delivers delicious sweets to both students and staff, adding a touch of magic to their journey aboard the train. Can we start talking about the Honeydukes sweets already? Bertie Bott's Every Flavor Beans, crafted by the inventive Bertie Bott, stood out as a beloved confectionery in the wizarding community, resembling muggle jelly beans, but with an extravagant twist. These magical beans boasted a spectrum of flavors surpassing ordinary treats, encompassing everything from delightful chocolate and refreshing peppermint to more peculiar tastes like spinach, liver, and tripe. Moreover, they featured whimsical and bizarre flavors that transcended conventional foods, including grass, vomit, and even bogies. Sold at 6 sickles per box, these beans became a staple for Hogwarts students, embracing the unpredictability and excitement that came with every mouthful. But now, let's explore the extensive array of other known flavors of Bertie Bott's. Almond, apple, banana, belly button lint, blackberry, black pepper, bogey, blueberry, blueberry pie, broccoli, buttered popcorn, candy floss, cherry, chicken, chili powder, chocolate cake, cinnamon, cranberry, cream puff, dirt, dirty sock, dog food, earthworm, envelope glue, farm dirt, feet, fish, fried egg, grape jelly, grapefruit, gravy, green apple, ham, honey, horseradish, ketchup, lemon, lobster, marmalade, marshmallow, mashed potatoes, mint, mustard, onion, orange, peach, pear, phlegm, pink grapefruit, pizza, roast beef, rotten egg, spaghetti, steak, sulfur, toffee, toffee apple, toffee pudding, tomato, troll boggy, tutti frutti, vanilla ice cream, and watermelon. Ah, there you are, my beloved viewers. Fear not, I'll be quicker than a golden snitch. First of all, I want to thank you all for being here for this episode of the Spellbook Chronicles. And if you think Quentin Pentagon is charming enough to deserve your generous support, you might consider leaving a like. And I highly recommend subscribing to the channel and clicking the bell icon to make sure you don't miss a single episode. Oh, but if you are wizards and witches truly hungry for knowledge, you might consider joining the channel for just a couple of galleons. Every month, you will be guaranteed priority access to all new videos on the channel. Plus, you will be rewarded every month with new exclusive special content just for you. So, what are you waiting for? butterbeer, a beloved beverage in the wizarding world, was renowned for its delectable taste, reminiscent of butterscotch, with a hint of sweetness. Available at various establishments throughout the magical realm, it was a favorite among Hogwarts students during visits to Hogsmeade. Whether enjoyed hot or cold, butterbeer was a quintessential part of wizarding culture. Served in cold bottles or foaming tankards, butterbeer could be found at iconic locales like the Three Broomsticks Inn, the Hog's Head Inn in Hogsmeade, and occasionally at the Leaky Cauldron in Diagon Alley. The recipe typically included butterscotch, sugar, and water, with variations crafted by skilled brewers like Madame Rosmerta, who infused hers with sugar shrub, mallow sweet, and moondew for an extra sweet flavor. While the standard price for a serving of butterbeer was 2 sickles, its availability and cost may have varied from place to place. Additionally, there were speciality versions such as Butterbeer 1707, renowned for its rarity and the option for delivery. Advertisements featuring Barney the Fruit Bat, mascot of the Ballycastle Bats Quidditch team, further popularized Butterbeer with slogans like, "I'm just batty about Butterbeer." These campaigns added to the drink's allure and cemented its status as a beloved beverage in the wizarding world. Chocolate frogs, cherished confections within the wizarding realm, were meticulously crafted from chocolate, fashioned into the delightful shape of a frog, captivating the senses and sparking the imagination of all who indulged in them. These delectable sweets contained a magical ingredient known as croco, comprising 70% of their composition, imbuing them with the ability to mimic the movements of real frogs through enchantment. In addition to the traditional milk chocolate variety, chocolate frogs were also available in a tantalizing white chocolate option, providing consumers with a delightful range of flavors to indulge in. A popular pastime among Hogwarts students was organizing playful competitions where they attempted to capture the hopping chocolates, distinguishing between the regular milk chocolate frogs and the elusive white chocolate ones. The allure of chocolate frog cards further heightened the appeal of these enchanting treats. Packaged alongside the chocolate frogs, these collectible cards featured portraits of famous witches and wizards, each with their own unique magical achievements and contributions to wizarding history. With over 101 known cards in circulation, avid collectors of chocolate frog cards cherished the opportunity to add rare and sought-after additions to their collections. These coveted cards were carefully stored in specialized albums, with famous witches and wizards typically housed in folio magi, while other notable figures, such as goblins, dragons, hags, and other beasts, found their place in the folio universitas. They also featured esteemed figures like Albus Dumbledore, Ptolemy, Circe, Paracelsus, Merlin, and Morgan Le Fay, each representing a significant contribution to the rich tapestry of magical history. In the enchanting realm of the wizarding world, a delightful array of confections awaits, rivaling the complexity and wonder of the spells themselves. Among the cherished treats adored by magical folk, several stand out as iconic symbols of sweetness and charm. Chocolate cauldrons. These delectable delights come packaged in boxes filled with fire whiskey-infused chocolate, tantalizing the taste buds with their rich flavor and mystical essence. Shaped like miniature cauldrons, they serve as both a delectable indulgence and a whimsical gift for fellow witches and wizards. Fizzing Whizbees, crafted by the renowned confectioner Queen Bee, Fizzing Whizbees are large sherbet balls that promise a delightful surprise with every bite. As the confection dissolves on the tongue, it imparts a fizzy sensation that lifts the consumer a few inches off the ground, eliciting gasps of wonder and joy. Licorice Wand, a creation resembling the iconic tool of wizards. The licorice wand is a sweet confection crafted from the finest licorice. Whether infused with traditional flavors or boasting a diverse range of taste sensations, these treats captivate the imagination with their enchanting appearance and irresistible allure. Ice Mice, a charming confection designed to evoke giggles and delight. Ice mice are sweets that cause the consumer's teeth to chatter and squeak with every bite. Pepper Imps, tiny yet potent. Pepper Imps are miniature black peppermint sweets that ignite the senses with their fiery flavor and playful effects. Eating these treats allows the consumer to breathe fire and experience a sensation of smoke emanating from their ears and nose. Elephant on a Bicycle, a whimsical confection crafted by Honeydukes, known for its ability to make the consumer mimic various animal noises, including those of a lion, an elephant, a monkey, and even a train whistle.
Pardon me, I had to freshen my mouth with an ice mug of butterbeer. Those darn Elephant on a Bicycle sweets. So, that brings us to the end of an episode that delved into the wonderful world of magical treats. I hope you enjoyed this sweet adventure as much as I did. Because dear wizards, witches, muggles, and squibs, always remember, in life as well as in the choice of sweets, it's important to let oneself be tempted by the most extravagant things. By the way, among the infinite flavors of Bertie Bott's Every Flavor Beans, which one would you like to try? Which one is the most bizarre, absurd you would like to taste? Write it in the comments. From Quentin Pendergren, your charming adventurer wizard. That's all for today. But stay tuned, because next episode of the Spellbook Chronicles promises even more magical adventure.